I got to know David Harrower's play when I directed it in Berlin. It really got under my skin then, and I became so fascinated with the knot of these two characters, and they haven't seen each other for 15 years. They have such huge questions for each other, and they're the only two people who can speak to each other about these questions. To do that, they have to go into very uncomfortable places for each other and for an audience to confront what happened between them and what shattered and changed their lives. That interested me very much in the theatre, but I was also very excited about what that would mean in the cinema, and how the camera might allow us to get close to these people in different ways. This film only works if it's the encounter between two people, and it's an incredibly raw encounter. They go to really painful places, so I needed two actors who would be incredibly brave, who would want to go all the way, and who would be really honest. And to my mind, Ben and Rooney are two of the greatest actors of their generation like that. I was really fascinated with Ben's rough truth, and with his ability to play this character who would keep us guessing about his true identity, and with Rooney's ferocity in trying to chase down that truth with him, but underneath that ferocity that she has, her fragile, tender heart, and excited to sort of see the chemistry that would happen between the two of them.
The specific challenges in taking the original production and adapting it for screen, because obviously it's a very different medium, but also innately claustrophobic, I guess.
Yes, I mean, the play, you're locked in a room with the two of them. The film, we open it up in different ways. We sort of get a chance to explore different aspects of their lives. But most importantly for me, the invitation of the cinema was to explore the past and to see how memories from the past, which are words in the theatre, but how in the cinema they become images that invite us to plunge into the past with them, and to find the spaces between the words and to find the silences in the language and what the camera sees and what images show that words can't say.
Do you feel that this is a film that's going to naturally provoke an increased dialogue about words like victim and what these words actually mean?
I think that's at the heart of this story, because she's a woman who is unable to really process what happened to her in the past, and she has a deep tear inside her over whether this was a love affair or with this was abuse, and it's certainly both of those things. But by trying to untangle this mess for herself, she invites us into a complex questioning and discussion of this theme ourselves. I hope that really continues for the audience afterwards. The aim of the filmmaking is that it's not tied up in a neat bow for you. It doesn't make it an easy pill to swallow, but as an audience, you have to continue the conversation afterwards.
What does it mean for you to bring the film here to Toronto and soon to the London Film Festival as well?
Yes, well, we premiered the film in Telluride, and to follow it here is a great thing. This is one of the world's great festivals for innovative and challenging world cinema, so it's just a thrill to be premiering it here tonight.